Hello guys, Ike here. Welcome back to the channel. We're back on the redstone testing world here with another redstone design for you today. And what we have for you today is a design that you're really going to want to know about. Anyways, for a long time, we have had standard sorting systems, namely this design here, which was noted to have been designed by Mr. Impulse SV, a really great redstoner. And the purpose of this was so that signal strengths coming out of the comparator, when using a filter system, you could actually stack them up to 64, but they wouldn't go over. The first slot in the hopper could go to 64, but then the signal strength wouldn't go over 3. That way it wouldn't spill over into the next bunch here. And that's a really great design. The only problem with this is that once you start getting a couple of these in, your world becomes really laggy. Because of the redstone. Redstone's really bad for lag. And part of it's lighting updates, part of it's just the way the code is set for redstone. And therefore, you know, once you get several of these sitting together and they're all sitting at signal strength 2, waiting on a tick to the third one, that means you've got, you know, say you have 15 filters here, that means you have 30 bits of redstone just lit up waiting for some more signal to spread them from a signal strength of 2 to a signal strength of 3. And that's a lot for the game to deal with, and especially when you've got a system of storage that's got pumpkin and melon farms coming in or mob drops coming in. And these things are constantly updating. It's going to create a lot of lag for you and for your server. And so what I've come up with today is a new design that should be a lot less laggy. For one, every module's only got one redstone dust, and we have the same amount of tile entities per dust, and then we have an inactive dropper here. Now this idea came to me based on there is a mechanic in the game that a lot of people don't know about. A lot of people might know about it, but the thing about it is that a lot of people have the understanding that it only works with furnaces. So there's a mechanic in the game where you could actually stick a block in a furnace. You can read a signal through a block into a comparator. And so what happens here is the comparator there is actually reading the signal off of the furnace. And you could even put some redstone power with this setup. You could actually power this dust and let's see, how do we want to do this? So if we power this dust, let's say over here. Oop, my bad. It's not going to read that block like that. It's still prioritizing the furnace. So if you put one in there, it'll do like that. However, if we were to place it there, even with that in there, you see, even with that there or not there, it'll then begin to read this here. And the reason for this is because placing this redstone block here gives this dust a signal strength of 15, and so until we get a signal strength of 15 in the dust, this comparator will actually always read this and not the dust. And like I said, we showed you that by that right there. And we can even go one further and show you that even in this direction it does nothing. So based on that, I did a little testing, and I came up with this design. It actually works with droppers too. That working that way means that we don't have to use furnaces, and furnaces actually create lag, where droppers don't create that amount of lag. As long as they're inactive or powered, which they're powered, they're not trying to hunt for something to do. So they're basically an inactive dropper, and not really adding anything to the processing of a chunk. So what we have here then, and how does this work? We have this comparator, and what we need to do is we need to send a signal strength of 15. The beauty of this, and it's actually tileable, because even if we send a signal strength of 1 here, or if we send a signal strength of 3, which would go all the way across, it still won't affect the comparator, because like I showed you a minute ago, it needs to be a 15 for this comparator to ignore this, which means that only the comparator that's putting out a signal strength of 15 can be 15, which means this comparator, if it's putting out 15, that one's 15, this one's 14, that one's 14, and it's not doing anything, and they don't stack. So if this one's 2 and that one's 14, you're still not going to get a signal strength of 15 here. And so we put it in this configuration so that once it gets a signal strength of 15, then we light up, turning off our torch. As you can see, I got like redstone in there, and I've got cobblestone coming in here and there. Yeah, so nothing's missed. Have tons of cobble going through. And I put the elevator and everything. I actually think it's to the point where it won't run anymore because they're in the wrong place. But point being, we can throw some stuff in there and it all gets sorted. What's in this one? Furnaces. How about that? Let's throw some furnaces in the line here and see what happens. See, it begins to activate that, but nothing else. And it'll burn out, but the beauty of that is, if it's going fast enough to burn out, that means you're getting enough items. It never misses. I've tested this for hours. Never misses. And so this, in theory, over a large storage system, even though it's a little bit larger as a downfall, should create a tremendous amount less lag in your world. Allow you to use larger storage systems if you want. And I just think it's beautiful. I'm going to be using this for everything for the future. So anyways, guys, I just wanted to share this with you, and I'll show you really quick how to build it, even though you probably don't need it. So if we just come up a little bit here, and so I'll just build one module. And the way I like to see this is that you're going to need this shape right here. It's kind of like a man diving. You get the shape of a guy head down, like he's diving head first into the ground. And then you're going to put one comparator that way, one comparator that way. You need a dust there and a dropper and that and a torch. Don't throw it on the ground, man. What's wrong with you? Yeah, a torch here. And then your filter hopper will be there. Now, that being said, let's talk about that really quickly. Now, how do we set up these filters? Because this is going to be different. Well, the beautiful thing is we're going to actually put wooden swords or any non-stackable item in here. And then you're going to let this stack up to 15 or 60, 63. So there's no worry of overflow here. It never can. It's not possible because 64 is the drop number. And same thing here, same thing there. And you also can rid yourself of, I believe, yeah, you're not really ridding yourself of a hopper, but you do have one extra bit of storage here. But yeah, anyways, guys, if you got any questions, comments, if you have anything to maybe add about this, it'd be great to hear down in the comments. Let me know. And until next time, guys, happy Minecraft, and I'll go ahead and add a few things. Check the description box. There will be links to TubeBuddy. There will be links to Discords. There will be links to social medias. Go check those things out and get into contact with me. And I'd like to get to know you guys a little bit better if you want to do that. And until next time, guys, again, happy Minecrafting. We will see you later.